Hey y'all, guess what day it is? Bow, guess what day it is? Bow, bow, guess what day it is? It's Vlogmas Day 8! Hey guys, little change in scenery. I'm waiting for the bus right now. I'm supposed to be here 4 minutes ago, but I think it's a little late. So I had to get the hell up on out of here. Anyway, just me sitting at the bus stop, waiting for Morta. Period. Waiting for the damn bus to pull up. Today was a pretty chill day at work. I'm here tomorrow and Monday, and then I won't be back until January. But yeah. I got me Breeze called. That's how you get on the bus. Oh, y'all. Oh, I swear to God. You'll be going through something. You're like, I just cannot wait to get the fuck over this stupid shit. Like, I swear to God, I cannot wait to get over my ex. Oh, love is for suckers. And it is for the weak. Don't have no interest in ever participating. I want to be one of those old single lesbians. I had this one boss, and she was like, I don't know how old she was. I know she was probably well into her probably 50s. She was white, so who knows? But she was old, and she ain't had no husband or no kids or shit like that. I never asked her about it because that's rude as fuck. But I hope y'all can hear me with all these cars. But I had, well, I thought my nose ring was gone. She kind of just mentioned like, oh, I just never wanted to get married or really have kids. But she had like, she said, I have friends, like little guy friends or whatever. I'm like, bitch, goes as fuck. Like, it saddens me that I'm going to be super rich and nobody to pass my stuff down to. But at least my goddaughter, she will be good. And my little cousins that I grew up with, they'll be good. But shit, fuck it. Fuck generational wealth, bitch. I'm trying to make some money for me. Oh, there's the bus. The bus is coming. Ooh. And it's fucking hot as hell. Like, I knew it was going to be warm today, but not this goddamn warm. Like, this sweater is... I know my face is hella oily. This sweater is killing me. Yep, the bus is only... Let me see. It's 8 minutes. Right? Or whatever. Who needs to be on time anywhere? Hola. So I just got home. It is almost 5 o'clock. I left work a little early. I was ready to go. Just walking. I was in the package room looking for a damn package that was supposed to be delivered. And I got probably like, damn bitch, how many motherfucking packages? A lot, okay? But honestly, I ordered some stuff off Amazon and then like a couple weeks ago, and really everything is just now starting to come. But I'm so annoyed, like I'm so annoyed. So y'all know I wait tables. Actually, I took y'all to work me, so yeah, y'all motherfucking know, y'all know what's up. And why the fuck did one of my managers text us, and he was like, no requests off until February. Bitch, what? Like, do you hear how dumb you sound, bitch? Like, and what kills me is I'm like, I know you're not gonna be here. One of y'all gonna wanna take the weekend off. I didn't even notice I had toothpaste on my damn self. Like, how the fuck is that shit fair? Like, you gonna tell somebody, you gonna tell all of us, oh, no requests off. Bitch, please, hold on. Let me get in the house. That wasn't even the right damn order. That wasn't even what I was looking for. Oh my God, it's 79 degrees in this fucking house. Oh. Please hush. God damn, I just walked in this motherfucker. Get out! Damn, that shit annoying as fuck. No, but it's really fucking 80 degrees in my house. I wish I would turn on the goddamn AC. Look at all those boxes. It's all shit I done ordered. Oh, child. Open up the window of my room. Oh, hold on. You got to open this motherfucker up, honey. Shit. Don't look at my fat, okay? These tights tight. I look like a can of damn Pillsbury biscuits from the bus out. But that wasn't even a damn package that I was waiting for. I'm so annoyed. That wasn't even the right package. I'm waiting on one more from Five Below. Y'all can't see my bottom. Whew, it's too hot to have clothes on. I can't deal. I'll keep a shirt on for you. Happy. But them flexi rides that I put in yesterday, honey, did not do shit. So, I like the waves. Should I put more flexi rides in or leave it as is? What do you think? Anyways, yeah, I was waiting on a package from Five Below. And I thought that was it, man. Oh, it is hot in the motherfucker. But yeah, so my boss texted us and was like, no requests off until February. It's barely December. You telling us for the next 2 months we can't request nothing off? Well, he said no weekends. And I'm just like, when I tell you this, that dumb shit I be talking about, like, this is that dumb shit that makes me hate working. How are you gonna tell somebody they can't request a weekend off? And what's bugging me, what's, you know, really bugging me is the fact that my birthday is in January. Like, my birthday is January 6th. So, you telling me, I'm sorry, let me rephrase. You think I'm going to work on my birthday? You're fucking nuts. If you think I'm working on my birthday when I don't work every fucking holiday up until now, then did every fucking convention, and I kind of like it like this. I'm going to put the flexi rods back in. But this time, we are going to use some foam. I'm going to use foam this time. Not a lot, though, because when I use a lot of foam, it'd be, like, really, like, crunchy. Like real stiff. So, we ain't going to do it. I ain't going to put a lot of foam in it. But this nigga really said no requests off. See, I got to do this as soon as I walk in the house or it ain't going to get done. Because when I take this wig off, baby, it get thrown on that mannequin head and that's it. Ugh, this stink. It smell like coochie. I'm childish. But, like, this is what really just pisses me off about being in the workforce. Like, for real, for real. Like, this nigga, like, and it's always been like this. This is not a new thing. I've been working for the past 11 years. Last month made 11 years that I have been working. 11 fucking years that I have been working. And working for other people. And, like, it's just, it be the same shit. It just be a different company. Like, for real. For real, for real. Like, how the fuck you gonna tell somebody they can't request a weekend off because it's gonna be busy? Bitch, what? You can at least be like, well, the weekend's off. It's not our fault that you don't have enough staff. Like, nigga, what? And then I know they gonna have the audacity to have motherfuckers working every fucking, like, all weekend. That's another thing that be killing me. Like, how the fuck you gonna have somebody work Friday, Saturday, and Sunday? Because our schedule stops on Saturday. Our schedule stops on Saturday. And, like, they'll be like, oh, well, because it was this guy. And when he had first started, he was like, well, I go to church every Sunday. Super religious. I'm not going to be saying that, but he's very religious. And he goes to church. And I think he plays, like, the drums or something at church. So he has to go. And he was like, hey, y'all, like, can y'all not schedule me on Sundays? Like, whatever. Like, I don't mind. My whole thing is, like, I'm a server. I've been working in the food service industry for 11 years.
I already know how to shit go. You're not getting no weekends off. You're not. And I used to be the type of person that would never really request off or like have like blackout days that like I could absolutely not work. But when I started working three jobs, I was like, you know what? Put me on a set schedule. Like, put me on a set schedule. Now, it's not set in stone, but when you work more than one job or even just working one, you need some specified time to your damn self. Like, you need time where you're not working, you're not getting ready for it. You deserve to make your own schedule. Don't be scared to make your own schedule. Like, fuck the niggas. Fuck that company. Fuck them. But that shit really, like, threw me. Like, I'm like, oh, well, I guess I'm finna get fired. Because, bitch, if you think I'm working on my birthday, you're dumb. And I already put the request in. So I put that request in weeks ago for my birthday. I ain't even probably gonna do shit for my birthday. But I'm taking off for my night job. I'm taking off Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. And then for my day job, I probably just won't go in there Friday. Maybe I. Because I think we go back. My birthday is on a Friday. And I think we go back to school. Like, school starts back up from the holiday on that Wednesday. So, you know, A days and B days, they'll be fine because they'll get one A day and one B day. They'll be all right. I'm just not going to be there that Friday. Like, I'm not working on my birthday. Like, I don't care if I don't do shit but sit in the house. I'm not working on my birthday. It's not happening. Like, these companies really fucking kill me. Like, you really just fixed your lips and was like, oh, well, I'm not. Nobody can request off for the next 2 months. Are you stupid? Like, that's not how you talk to your staff. He could have been like, hey, like, we really busy. And so for the next for the next 2 months, like, time off requests are going to be very limited because we have blackout days. That's what they call them, blackout fucking days. Bitch, I don't give a motherfuck. If you think I'm finna come up in there on my motherfucking birthday after working again every holiday, every convention, volunteering to go to banquets. I literally just worked from 9 a.m. until freaking 1:30 in the morning. I'm not like y'all was with me at work. I was legit there all night. Made great money, but still, like, I'm telling you, these companies don't appreciate dog shit. Like, and it's cool. You know what I'm saying? Like, I've come to terms with the shit. A lot of people be, like, so surprised and shit. Like, oh, my God. How could the company do that? How could they do that? Like, what? Like, why are you surprised? Like, oh, my God. They fired that lady after working there? Like, no. I had this lady tell me. She was like, I worked for a company for, like, 30 years. On her anniversary! On her 30 or 35, 40, whatever she said, on her anniversary, they gave her a pink slip. And I know you old enough to know what a pink slip is. Bitch, they fired her on her 30-year anniversary. I don't know when I realized these companies won't shit, but I've always known that I'm not meant for this, like, this stupid shit. Like, I'm not going to say the 9-to-5 because I got plans. And my plans involve being a speech therapist. So unless I start my own company, I'm going to have to work for somebody else. So I'm not going to be like, well, I don't like this 9-to-5. I'm just tired of these little entry-level, low-level jobs is what I'm motherfucking tired of, baby. Like, let me tell you. Let me freaking tell you. Like, I just can't believe he said that. Like, no request off until February. Huh? Nigga, what? I mean, I don't really care. I need the money anyway. So I'm still trying to figure out how I want to do my schedule because I can't keep going from like working both jobs in one day. I just don't want to do it. Like, and I'm kind of stressed out, you know, with the holiday coming up because I'm gonna be out of work for basically 3 weeks with no pay. And it's a little concerning to me. I'm just spraying alcohol on my wig to get the glue off the edges because I used the spray and it got to be spray. But yeah, like, I've been doing this shit for so long and I swear, like, this is nothing new. Like, this is not some new phenomenon, like, that they are being assholes about trying to take some time off. Like, all companies are like that. Like, that shit is wild. Like, I'm just so astonished. Like, they really said that, like, no request off. I can't believe how hot it is. Like, legit, y'all, when I looked at the weather earlier this week, it said like 52, 52, 60 something, 74. And I was like, what the fuck did that shit just say? 74 fucking degrees. This is my latest Amazon package. It's literally nothing exciting at all. I thought this was my Five Alone for real. I just got some Swiffer Jet refills. And I really like these. These are the antibacterial ones. Kills 99.99999% of bacteria. Because I have a Swiffer wet jet. I need to get them out. Look at this enormous pile of freaking boxes that need to go outside. The fucking trash compactor is literally all the way on the other side of the complex. And I'm not walking over there. So it's like 5 o'clock. Honestly, y'all, I don't feel like doing shit. I don't know if I should just chill out for a little bit. Like, I just like to get shit done. Like, when I get home, I just like to start my work. You know, with Vlogmas, come home, edit my video, work on my planner. I made like 4 planners today. I literally made like 4 or 5 planners. So like, I worked on my journal some today and I made a couple. So I guess I just want to talk about like the different business ventures that I'm getting into this coming year. I know I look so crazy, but y'all, this is real fucking life. I've been wearing that wig since 6 something this morning. It was time for it to come off. One of the business ventures that I am getting into this coming year is drop shipping. If you don't know what drop shipping is, it's basically when you purchase a product. Well, you have customers and they order products from you, and instead of you shipping it out to them, they get it from a factory. So say like, oh no, it could be anything. Say I sell hair and you purchase hair from me from my website, from Courtney's WeValiciousBundles.com. Instead of me holding inventory wherever in my home, my office, and shipping it out to you and dealing with all logistics, I X all that out and I contact the factory directly, and the factory sends you your stuff, or the manufacturer will send you your stuff. Dropshipping has been around for ages. People always say, isn't it illegal? Isn't it illegal? Shut the fuck up. No, it's not. Amazon is a dropshipping company. Target.com, Walmart.com, those are both drop shipping companies. Like, they drop ship their stuff. Like, that stuff doesn't come from, now maybe Target and, you know, they have like a warehouse or whatever, but like Amazon, anybody can sell on Amazon. So it's not the company selling you products, it's vendors on Amazon selling you products. That's why I'd be like 20,000 the same thing. If it was one company, they wouldn't have 29 options. Like, that's why it's called Amazon drop shipping, or, you know, you can do Amazon FBA, which is different, which is where you actually purchase the products, but you still send it to Amazon and they ship it out for you. So it's still drop shipping. Like, it's all the same. So no, it's not illegal. It's, I don't understand why you think that. Like, it's the same thing. If you go into Target or Walmart and you purchase a product from them, like say you want some baked beans. I don't know why baked beans be always the example in my mind, but say you want some baked beans, you go to Walmart or Target. Is it one or two? Or is it like 7 different brands of like baked beans, 7 different brands of pizzas and frozen french fries and vegetables, like, and desserts and cookies and cakes and chips? Like, it's a reason for that. Like, that's how they make their money. The same reason why the prices are different at different stores, like, because they mark up their stuff however they want to mark it up. But anyways, if you want to learn more about drop shipping, Google it. Like, it's not that hard. So yeah, drop shipping is one of the things that I'm getting into this year. I actually already have my website. It's launched. It's pretty much done. I gotta go in and tweak some stuff, but that's finished. So apart from drop shipping, my other business ventures, I plan on having some vending machines around town, around Atlanta. I plan on having vending machines around town, and then I plan on getting into Airbnb. So all that's kind of linear. Like, I chose drop shipping because I had thought about drop shipping years and years and years and years and years ago. Like, it's very easy to get started. When I say easy, I don't mean like it's not a lot of work, because it's definitely tedious and it's a lot of work, but what I mean is I don't have to save up buku bucks. Like, it's easy to get started financially. Like, all you gotta do is build your website. That costs me a dollar. Get a domain. You only have to get a domain, which is the www.whatever.com. That's a domain. Pay for that. Pay for hosting through Shopify. And then find some products online. And then you just mark them up, put them on your website. And like, that's it. Like, and the money that you get, you know, from, you know, revenue and then breaking it down to profit, you just put that shit back in your business for advertisement. And then you keep getting more people to your store. You keep doing whatever you want to do. Whether that's scaling or switching out your products or taking off product, like literally anything, you can do whatever. So that's why I chose drop shipping. And then the vending machines, my boxes are tumbling. Y'all saw that. And then the vending machines I chose because I felt as though, like, I just think it's such a cute little idea. I don't know why I wanted. I was just thinking of passive income ideas, y'all. Like, I literally have a whole list somewhere in here of all of the different business ventures that I want to do, like, for my life in general. Not just coming up or whatever the case may be, but for, I think it's in October. Yep, right here. Whole list. These are all business ideas. So, yes, I was thinking about passive income, meaning money that's just coming in and I don't really have to do anything for it. So, like, not a 9-to-5, not whatever, like, just passive income. So, I have a bunch down. So, I'll read some out to y'all in case y'all looking for passive income ideas. This is just literally a drop in the bucket of what you can do for passive income. So, vending machines, being a courier, like a medical courier, look it up on TikTok. Amazon seller, drop shipping, Airbnb, reselling or flipping stuff, laundromats, not really passive. I don't know why I wrote that under. And then the judges and company, again, not really passive. Don't know why I put that up here. But I was just thinking the things that I could do to make extra money because I'm just tired of working two jobs. Like, I'm tired of I'm tired of working one job. But I'm namely tired of working my ass off, working 40 plus hours a week and still struggling. Like, my phone's off. I'm keeping up with y'all. I mentioned this in the previous vlog. My fucking phone is off. Maybe some shit finna get sent to collection soon here. Like, I gotta keep a roof over my head first and foremost. And always, I gotta keep a roof over my head. Like, I can't be sitting here trying to flex. Like, oh, my phone. Like, nobody calls me. And I don't call anybody. I have an iPhone. As long as you got another iPhone and we got them blue bubbles popping, like, you can message me. It's not that serious. I have to prioritize shit. And I'm tired of doing that. Like, I'm tired of choosing between this bill and that bill and this and that. I'm tired of choosing between that. Like, I just want to be good. You know what I'm saying? So, that is where the passive income is coming from. Like, I want to know that, like, say I already had all these going, or I had some of these going, I was making enough money. Even if it doesn't even have to be a full-time income, as long as, like, for the next 3 weeks from, like, work or whatever, I would be good. I wouldn't be like, oh my God, what I'm gonna do? Like, I gotta pick up some extra shits. I gotta work extra hard. Da-da-da-da-da-da. I don't gotta do all that. Like, I can just be good and be like, okay, I can relax. I got 3 whole weeks. I'm finna chill. I'm finna bit chill at home, work on my other shit, and just bit chill. Not stressing all the time, and I'm just so freaking over it. I am over it. But yeah, so the vending machines, the drop shipping store, and the Airbnb are some things I plan on getting into next. Yeah, I'm scared about Airbnb. I feel like I ain't gonna like it. I feel like I'm not gonna like this shit at all. But I want to try it. It looks like another decent form of income, like passive income. Like, these things aren't what's gonna make me a millionaire, but it's what's gonna get me started. Like, drop shipping, you can easily make 6 figures a month, like 5-6 figures a month drop shipping. Easily make 6 figures a year doing Airbnb. That's extra money. That's passive income. That's not my main income. So, apart from those three business ventures that I plan on getting into, and they're linear, meaning the drop shipping is gonna help fund the vending machine, which is gonna help fund the Airbnb. That's why it's in that order. Because an Airbnb and a vending machine, you have to have a lot of money up front, especially for Airbnb. You're literally getting an apartment and furnishing it completely. Like, furnishing it, getting all the little accessories and decorations. Like, I imagine you gotta have saved up somewhere around probably like 10 bands to get started. Like, that's a lot of money. Ain't got it. Vending machines, you gotta buy the machine, you gotta find somewhere to put it. Like, you gotta get snacks for it, you gotta keep refilling it again. Lots of money. Drop shipping takes, you can start drop shipping with $0. Like, basically, I did. The only thing I paid for was, like I said, my domain, my hosting, which is what Shopify is. It's a hosting company. And then like little apps and stuff that I pay for, but it's like $10 a month. With it, like a little shit. Like it's not expensive at all. Like you can start your shit. You can do well with it. I have my digital products, which are like planners and stuff you can use on your phone or your tablet. And then I have physical products, which this is something that I actually made. I'm so proud of myself. I still use it to this day. Like still use it. It's a business plan, and I actually just remade it, but it's digital. This one that I made is digital. I kind of wanted to focus on digital products only at the moment. Like I didn't really want to get into physical products because you gotta like trying to find somebody to print this out that doesn't cost a lot of money, and you gotta order samples and make sure it looks good. I ain't got time for that right now. So right now I'm just focusing on my digital products because that's easy. I just make it and I sell it. And today I discovered another little side hustle, or another little like way to like help boost my digital products. It's called PLR, which is just private label rights, which means somebody else can make something and I can buy it off them and resell it. I can tweak it and resell it. And I'm just sitting up here like, my mind was blown when I seen that shit. I'm like sitting up here thinking that people, basically it's like ghostwriting. It's like if somebody made this and I purchased it from them, I purchased the rights from them to resell it. Because when somebody makes something, you can't just take it and resell it. That's illegal. But if somebody were to make this and then I bought it off them and I resold it, if it was digital or whatever, I don't know if PLR works for physical products. I guess the what that would be called is white labeling, which is basically like if I bought like 100 of these shirts and I put my own label, my own tag and everything up there, that's kind of white labeling because I didn't make the product. I'm just putting my name on it. I hope that shit makes sense. But anywho, yes, my digital products and then my YouTube channel and social media. I plan on redoing my whole website, so getting back into blogging. I have not blogged in years. The last blog post I wrote was when President Biden and Vice President Harris were elected, and I did an article on Ms. Harris being the first Black VP of these United States. Which was amazing, amazing, amazing. That's really it as far as my focus. So my goal is to be done punching the clock by the end of this school year, which is like really ambitious, but I know that I can do it. Like, I'm just tired, or at least only work at my night job and just be part-time because I'm going back to school next year and I'm not gonna have time to work during the day. Like, my boss is like, well, I want you to keep working. No, I'm gonna be in college. Like, I'm going to get my master's in speech and language pathology. The school is online, so I guess I could try and swing some stuff, but I don't want to. I just genuinely do not want to. Like, I don't want to work a 9-to-5 and a 5-to-9 and be in school. I'm not. I know that I'm not old and I'm not 60 and I'm not like, well, I put in 40 years at my job. 11 years is more than enough, honey, okay? I'm just tired of getting up, having this long ass commute, going to this place where I have no control over shit. I'm just there. I'm just being told what to do. And then, you know, you got to deal with all this bullshit and drama, especially you got shitty coworkers. I don't got shitty coworkers, luckily. Not anymore. I've had some terrible fucking experiences, but not anymore. But it's just like really being like pretty much under somebody's thumb all the time. Like, I'm tired of that shit. Like, I want to wake up when I feel like waking up. And I'm an early bird. I'm not lazy. Like, I'm not lazy at all. Like, this shit right here, this book right here, hey, like, this not my template. This is, all these dots at the fucking place. This shit right here is individual boxes. Like, this was not a template. Like, I had to place these boxes, place everything on this page I placed, like, by hand. Like, this fucking calendar was a pain in the ass to make because there's two separate pages and you can't put the two things beside each other. So I had to make sure it was straight. Like, this shit, I had to place all these lines, all these boxes. Like, I'm not lazy. Like, I know what I want to do. This shit is a lot of work. Like, it's not super hard, but it's not like a piece of cake neither. Like, it takes time and effort. Then you gotta market it and sell it. Like, I'm not lazy, but I'm so tired of doing what other people tell me to do. Like, I want to wake up when I feel like waking up. I want to make as much money as I possibly can. Like, the fact, the idea that you can literally sit at home and from your computer just make 6-7 figures and you be good. Like, what the fuck? Like, I read this post earlier. It said now people have it so easy nowadays to get like to get rich, not rich, but like to be well off. Like you can literally make money from your computer. You can make money starting your own business. You can make money doing so much shit. Like what the fuck is a remote closer? I keep saying that shit on TikTok, but I'm just like, I want so much more for myself. Like my vision for my life is just to have a my own boss, be running like hella companies, and to be a speech language therapist. Like I'm gonna get my doctorate in speech and language pathology or speech therapy. So I'm getting my master's and I'm getting my doctorate. But I want to be a professor when I get older. Like I want to be a professor at a university, and that's gonna require me to work for somebody else. But I wanna want to work. I don't wanna need to work. Like I don't wanna be like, I see so many people, namely older Black people, and they all hunched over and they walking all funny and their knees are bad and they had a hip replacement because they on their feet and they've been on their feet for the last 20, 30 years. I cannot let that be me. Like, no, my back already hurt. I can't I'm not finna be 40, 50 years old going and then having and what really 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 just be so astonishing to me is that it be people that are older than me, probably my grandma, and they working with me and I done came in and I'm making more money than you. Like I was a supervisor at plenty of places, but I had saw one of my coworkers' check because I was handing out the check stubs, and I had seen her check and I was like, that's all she made? Like, huh? She was had been in a job for 20 years. And I said, that's all she make? It's not for me. It's not for me. It's giving slave. Then they could just fire you at any time. You could lose your job. You can get laid off. Like, So, yeah, those are my different business ventures. That's my plan for my life. Before I become a professor, though, I definitely want to just work in hospitals and just get some experience so I have shit to talk about during my class times. But I'm just like, that's what I want to do in my life. Like, I want to be a professor, and I want to be the richest professor on campus because I have my own business. And if I don't like this job, I can go to another one. I can go to another one. I can take 10 years off if I fucking feel like. I want to live my fucking life. I want to travel. I want to meet people. I want to do crazy things. I want to make memories. I want to have a fucking ball. But I can't because I'm always at work. And so that's why I'm just like, now it's really time to like put motherfucking the pedal to the motherfucking metal. Did I say that right? Put metal to the, I don't know. It's time to put my foot on the motherfucking gas. It's time to really hustle my ass off and get this shit because I'm on TikTok and I see people doing the same shit. That's how I know I can be successful with this shit because I've seen other people do it. When you witness other people doing stuff, other people making six figures doing shit, then you know for a fact that you can do it too. So I'm gonna go ahead and show y'all. Give me the next gear and I'm gonna show y'all. And they're like, oh my God, how did you do that? How did you do that? Remember this moment. Remember me poor. Remember me poor and tired and looking all crazy. Remember this, okay? Remember this, okay? Remember it. Because this shit finna be over. This poor shit finna be over. I can't do it. Oh, anyways. Let me show y'all my vision board. It's not backwards, is it? Is that backwards? You think it's gonna be backwards? Anyways, this is my vision board, my goal board, whatever you wanna call it. The reason why I use push pins and it's not all cute because whenever I accomplish a goal, I take it off, I put it in the bag, and then I write the date that I accomplished it on it. So this is everything I wanted to like, you know, get and stuff. So everything's up here. Sales for my business. My vending machine is up here. What else is up here? A lot of stuff. Literally everything that I want. Everything that I want to purchase. Everything that I want to accomplish is on this board. See up there? That's me graduating, getting my master's. See, it says CCC-SLPD, which is basically the doctor of speech therapy. That's up here too. So I just think that that's a more functional way to like have a vision board versus having this cute little picture and it kind of just collect dust in the corner versus this is like, all right, I'm trying to pull these motherfuckers off. So anyways, I'm gonna stop rambling. I'm gonna go ahead and edit this video and I'm working my products some more, period. Anyways, thank you all so much for watching today's video. Hope you all enjoyed it. Don't forget to smash that red subscribe button down below, show your girl some love, and follow me on social media at Young and Kinky because let's be friends. Anyways, thank you all for so... Did I? I don't think I started my vlog off right earlier. I didn't. Because I was just walking. I'm going to do it in a second. But what the fuck was I saying? Thank you all so much for watching today's vlog. And I will see y'all tomorrow for Vlogmas Day. What's today? I keep fucking up. For Vlogmas Day 9. Vlogmas Day 9. Bye.